Welcome back. Once again, we're back here at the bench with the International Harvester Red 66 project. For those who are just joining us for the first time, this machine is a Singer 66-1 from 1915-ish. It was originally a red eye. The original paint and decals were almost completely shot, completely gone. There was very little of the red eye decals left, and the paint was in horrible condition. So I figured, what the heck, as an experiment, let's just play around, have a little fun. I mean, this machine, I think I have $10 into, or had $10 into before I bought the paint. And I stripped the paint off of her, reprimed her, and painted her with the magic tractor, truck, and implement spray that I got at Tractor Supply. This particular color is International Harvester Red. It's the code number on it is 8-22972-8. Put two or three coats. Actually, I think it took three coats of paint, and then let that set up for a week or so. And I hit it with one coat of clear, put the decals on it, and then like three coats of clear on top of that. And then when we started the assembly, we started by putting the main shaft and the vertical rock shaft back in. Those are working fine now. And these things are always a little clunky. But that's all back in. So today, for part two of the reassembly, we are going to work on the bottom of the machine, and we're going to put the feed assembly in. We're going to put a portion of the hook driving assembly, because that's required for the feed. I'm not going to bother to put the hook in today. I'm going to hold off on that, because in part three, we'll be putting the hook in and we'll be doing the needle bar. But so today, we're just going to concern ourselves with driving the feed dogs and getting the feed dogs set up properly in the needle plate. So give me a couple seconds to get reorganized here and reset the shot up so you can see what's going on. And we will get right into this. In front of you here, you see the parts that are going to be going back into the machine at for this portion of the video. Seeing how we're only going to be doing the feed mechanism, we'll have the forked arm, which is driven off the cam on the main shaft. It is controlled with the sliding block and the screw type stitch length adjuster. We will put in the bell crank that drives the hook, though we will not be putting the hook in. And the reason we do that is on this bell crank, this portion that is cut away here in the bell crank is actually the cam that the lifter for the feed dogs rides in. So this is what makes the feed dogs go up and down. Of course, we'll put in the feed dog rock shaft, which just gives us the forward and backward motion of the feed dogs. And we'll be putting on, to make all these adjustments, we're going to have the needle plate in the machine. And we'll be able to adjust, in the section we're doing now, we'll be able to adjust the fore and aft motion, as well as the lateral motion, the side-to-side positioning of the feed dogs. And of course, the this rock shaft pivots on these two pivot screws, which are held in place with these lock nuts. Now, I have already reassembled this portion of the machine and took it apart again. The reason I did that was because in the painting process, some of these little plugs that I used to keep the threaded areas, a couple of them popped off at a couple times and I didn't really notice it. And I wound up getting a lot of clear paint inside some of the threaded areas of the casting. So I had to clean those chase those threads out. I didn't have taps for a lot of them, so I wound up using certain parts of the machine hardware to chase those threads. So I wound up putting the machine together, or let's just say this portion of the machine together, made sure that it was going to work just fine, took it apart again, re-cleaned the parts, and we're just going to take it from there. So, but as a matter of full disclosure, I have put these parts back in the machine. Also, as a matter of full disclosure, these pivot screws with their associated lock nuts, they're not nailed down in the exact location, proper spacing that they're supposed to be or where they're going to wind up being, but they're pretty close. So that too saved a bit of time. Anyway, let me get some of this stuff off to the side, bring the machine back up, get the camera set up so you can see what's going on, and we will get started. Okay, we're going to start by putting the needle plate on this machine. Simple enough exercise to do. I'm using my little Craftsman ratcheting screwdriver. Absolutely love this one. Okay. It's one screw in. There we go. All right. And next up on the hit parade, we'll go ahead and we're going to stick the front pivot screw. Now, like I said, these are not exactly where they're going to go. They're pretty close, but I'm going to leave them a little bit loose. Okay, front pivot screw is in. Next piece, I'm going to put in the pivot point and the, it's kind of an odd looking bolt, as you can see here. Let me see if I can get that, the camera can see it. You have multiple threaded areas threaded here with a little flange. This is what This is what the bell crank is going to ride on. And that goes down here. Now for tightening this up, I just use, of course I've got it in a position here where that's not going to work. All right. I just use this little punch just to get that last bit. And this is not something that has to be super tight. You can use this, I'm going to use this little punch kind of like a wrench just to get her tweaked in there. Okay, that'll work. That's close enough. All right, the feed dogs are going to go on raised all the way. I'm holding them up with my finger. Just going to screw it on. And the reason they're doing that is that way we know we have the teeth of the feed dog in the associated holes on the needle plate. So I'm going to put that there. Now I'm going to start the pivot screw on the other side. Now I believe I have covered in a previous video the adjustments of these pivot screws, but I will go through it again. Let me loosen that nut up. Run that in a little bit. Just yell down front if I get in the way. All right, now, This is why I wanted those feed dogs up all the way on the rock shaft. Now they're up all the way, but I've got way more space than I need. I have to loosen. I actually put these in opposite sides where they were before. I'm going to stand and look over here. Pardon me for just a moment. I'm going to have to loosen this nut up. All right, now, those are in a good spot. I'm going to pull this out and check my lateral. There's a little bit of lateral motion there, but those are in good stead there. So let me just double check my tightness on this end. That's a little too tight. There we go. That's in good spot. No lateral motion. We're fine. So, I'm going to take my wrench, and actually use a bigger screwdriver than that. I'm going to hold the screw, the set screw, in position while I tighten the locking nut, the jam nut. I believe I mentioned in previous video, I know I mentioned in part two of the Singer 192K video that my wife is a musical instrument repair tech and that she taught me how to do my own saxophones. Well, there are certain brands of saxophones that use this exact type of a setup of pivot screw and locking nut. And that was my first introduction to this as a pivot system. I'm going to try to do this without getting in your way too much. Get that one there and get the nut tightened. Okay. Now we have good motion. I can feel the feed dogs are through and there's no lateral slop here. Mission accomplished. Let's move on. Next piece we're going to insert, we'll put the linkage to the bell crank. Now, the bell crank linkage has to be pre-assembled at the bell crank end, or it's not going to work. So this has to go together. Let me grab the appropriate screw. Should be this one. This bolt goes through this end here and then goes on to the bell crank. Okay, and that will go thusly and it'll pop right on to the vertical shaft. Vertical shaft end screw is right here. Get that in place. Now on this end, you see we've got good motion there. Now we have the lifter and its appropriate hardware. The lifter is going to ride in the cam on the bell crank, and the fork in the lifter will grab this bearing here. So that just slides like that. Its appropriate bolt line up goes thusly. Okay. And like I said, if I'm getting in the way, just yell, "Hey, down front." It is so much easier to do this when I'm not trying to make it so you can see, but you're the reason for the video, not me. All right, now there's this last piece of hardware that needs to go on. It has a set screw that rides in this groove here, where the interrupted portion of the threads are. It rides in that, so we're going to screw this down. And of course, it's going to be aimed down here. So I'll do it off camera, but I'll have to tilt the machine up and tighten that screw once we have it at a good tension. Actually, no, you'll be able to see it because if it's too tight, and that's too tight, you don't want it tight. You want it so that's nice and free. So I can get to it. All right, still nice and free. So let's get the feed assembly together. Let me reposition the machine and I'll bring you back for that. All right, we've done this a million times before. Well, maybe not a million. We've done this a number of times before. So let's do it again. First step up, with the little bearing piece of steel in place. Actually, make sure it's nice and clean, which it is. Now that I got the shmoo off, we get the bearing on. We're going to insert the feed fork through the bottom of the machine and get it to go up and into the cam on the main shaft. It can just sit there for just a second all by its lonesome. And we're going to put the other end resting on the driven point on the bottom. Actually, better than resting. Let's take the eccentric bolt and put that in. We won't bother with the nut just yet. Or should say, we won't tighten the nut just yet. We'll put the eccentric bolt in. Takes a little turning to get it going. Just lightly put the nut on. Now is the fun part. And we've all seen this before, hopefully. We will start with just putting a few turns of the screw adjuster in. Now, this little nub here is going to be engaging in the screw adjuster, so I'm going to take my tweezers. Like I said, we've gone through this as a whole video on this already. I'm going to take the tweezers. Get this oriented down the hole. Get her pretty much lined up. And we want to make sure that the arm on the bottom, the driving arm from the vertical rock shaft, is in a horizontal position. And we simply slip the adjuster into position. We're going to have to thread that in a little bit more. Okay, I've got it on it now, and it's in place. All right, line up the threaded portion of the block. Take the pivot with the locking bolt with its lock washer. This machine was not intended to be, and I had never intended this project to be the great, oh, look how fantastic this machine is project. This was basically a hoot. I did this as a, let's see what happens kind of thing. Okay, now that we've got that linkage in place, it's time to adjust that eccentric bolt. The eccentric bolt on the forked shaft controls the fore and aft positioning of the feed dogs in the needle plate. So you can see here, as I turn this through, we have more feed dog towards the front than we do towards the rear. There's more up here than back here. So we're going to make that adjustment. Okay, I have the drive set so that the feed dogs are still up, but they're towards the back. And I've got them pretty much where I want them, towards the back. But I'm going to make sure that they're as much towards the back as I'm going to get before they go down. And that looks to be at about this. Hold on. I'm afraid you didn't see what I just did. All right, notice how I am holding the eccentric bolt and adjusting with the wrench. Once the adjustment is in the position I want, hold with the screwdriver, tighten with the wrench. In this case, the wrench is a 7/16. I should have mentioned, and I didn't, when adjusting the fore and aft position of the feed dogs using the eccentric bolt here, make sure that your stitch length is set to the maximum. I'm not really worried about the feed dog height on this machine right now, because the feed dogs have to come out again anyway to put the hook back in. So anyway, that's about it. That's all that wraps up part two. You'll see underneath that everything seems to be working correctly now. We've got good motion of the hook driver. The feed dogs are going fore and aft, and they are going up and down. So for the next portion in part three, we'll start off with putting the needle bar area together and putting the hook back together, and we'll even stick the upper thread tensioner in, and we'll finish the machine up. As always, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. It really does help. And we will see you on the next one for part three.